The last lesson talked about passwords and why they are so important. But something that is just as important is two-factor authentication, or 2FA, as all the cool kids say, which as it sounds is a second form of authentication required to access an account. This could be verifying a code sent to your phone number after you put in your password. It can be a second password requirement, a code from an app like Authy or Google Authenticator, a USB key, or security questions can work as well. We'll cover more after this short message. If you're watching Go Incognito, my guess is you're at least passionate about either digital privacy, security, or possibly both. If you are, become a part of the Techlore community, where we have thousands of other passionate people spread across different platforms, like Demon Instagram for the noobs, Holy Telegram for the more advanced, and our other fun communities like, obviously, YouTube, subscribe, Discord, and, Minds. I don't know, do something. Lastly, there's now a subreddit, r/Techlore, where I encourage you to post some of your questions and content for other privacy and security advocates to see. This is aimed to be a more welcoming and community-oriented version of our privacy. That is all, lemurs. I hope to see you on our platforms and enjoy the rest of the free lesson. The idea with 2FA is even if your password fails you, you are still protected. Maybe a service you use gets hacked and someone gets your password. Maybe you're tricked into handing your password over through social engineering, a scammer, a phishing site, or maybe your password is brute forced. This stuff can happen to even the best of us. But even if someone has your password, which assuming you followed your OPSEC is only being used on that one service, they still can't gain access to the account because additional authentication is required. It's similar to movies where in order to authorize access, you need to have two people turn a key at the same time to unlock the door. This is all great in theory, but not every form of 2FA is necessarily created equal. The most common form of 2FA is an SMS text message sent to your phone with a code. The site asks what the code is and you simply type it in. Most of us have done this. This seems extremely secure. Well, not really. Lots of cell phone providers are known to have weak security when it comes to social engineering, something we'll talk about down the road in the course. Someone can call your cell phone provider pretending to be you and forward all the SMS messages to them. This actually happened to Linus Tech Tips, leading to the compromise of their Twitter page and their website, as well as many other YouTubers, including Boogie2988. On top of this, Kevin Mitnick in the book The Art of Invisibility discusses a pretty easy social engineering technique that exploits SMS two-factor authentication. Here's what he said. Say I want to take over your email account and I don't know your password. I do know your cell phone number because you're easy to find through Google. I can go to the reset page for your email service and request a password reset, which, because you enable 2FA, will result in an SMS code sent to your phone. Mitnick then directly social engineers the person by texting them a non-suspicious text from Google saying, Google has detected unusual activity on your account. Please respond with the code sent to your mobile device to stop unauthorized activity. So it's really cool. He's impersonating Google here to get a user to send over the 2FA authentication code. Now that Mitnick has the code, he has all the information he needs to reset the account password and gain access. On top of all of this, SMS is unencrypted, opening up the potential for SMS sniffing. We're going to talk more about that in lesson 3.15, Safe Communication. Because of all of these SMS risks, I highly recommend avoiding SMS 2FA, unless it's the only option available, which unfortunately does happen with some people who don't care about security. If your account only gives you the option to use text verification, I encourage you speak your voice and push them to be more secure. But do remember that having text 2FA is better than nothing. So what is proper two-factor authentication for all of us that are too privileged for text 2FA? Well, one solution is an app which generates keys for you. The reason these are so much more secure is most never touch the internet or any communication protocols. They locally store keys generated onto your devices, making it extremely difficult for anyone to get these keys outside someone with physical access to your device, which should only be you. There are tons of apps that give you this functionality, and to be perfectly honest, this is one of those few areas of the course where I'm going to tell you it doesn't really matter too much which one you go with. It's mostly personal preference. These are simple apps, and all they do is generate new keys for you every 30 seconds. that's really it. The way it works is you scan a QR code for the service you're signing up for, and now it'll generate codes for you to use. Probably the most popular FOSS authenticator is Authy, but it offers cloud syncing and key backups, which is something we don't really want. We want all of this to be stored locally for better security. You can use Authy, just make sure to avoid the features inside of it. Alternatively, I'd recommend free OTP for iOS and OTP for Android. These are both FOSS, much more limited than Authy, and get the job done, in my opinion, just as well. The last topic I want to cover is physical two-factor authentication, and this comes in many different shapes and sizes, so there are no specific rules or information to follow since everybody's digital life is set up a bit differently. You can require a password in addition to a USB key to get into your operating systems, so the USB key is functioning as an additional authentication requirement. This can work with full disk encryption as well. Something like YubiKey is great for this, or you can turn any flash drive into a device as well. You can use a TPM module if your computer supports it, so that your drives can only be booted from a specified computer, and there are hundreds of different products out there that have their own proprietary version of physical 2FA. Like I said, there's nothing in particular I'm going to recommend, but just be aware that these products do exist and that you can use them. That is everything I have to say about two-factor authentication. You can have the world's strongest password, but you're as strong as your weakest link. Don't let the lack of 2FA be your weak link. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson, search engines.